Hello friends, I am Sampada Kulkarni, welcomes you in my channel Tech Talks. Here I am presenting a video series on the topic graph, a non-linear data structure. I am trying to explain all the things related to graph data structure. For your reference, I am providing a shortcut link in this write-up corner where you will find everything about graph data structure. Before moving to the content, I would like to request you to subscribe my channel Tech Talks and keep the bell ringing. From this video series, in the current video, I am trying to explain the representation of graph data structure. How to represent the graph data structure as far as the programming is concerned with respect to graph data structure. So first of all, take a glance about what is a graph or a graph data structure. So graph is a non-linear data structure. If you want to know more about the meaning, the explanation about non-linear data structure, you can go through my previous video, types of data structure, for which I am providing a shortcut link in this write-up corner. So graph is nothing but the combination of two different sets, where the first set is nothing but of nodes, or it is also called as vertices, and the second set is nothing but of the edges. That edges are used to connect two different nodes. So this combination is useful for what? So set of nodes are useful to store the information about the vertices, and the set of edges is useful to describe the relationship among the vertices. So in short, graph is nothing but the combination of set of nodes and set of edges. I have already explained the details about graph, the introduction of graph, as well as different types of graph in my previous video. You can go through that and then you can resume this video. Here I am trying to give you the real-time example of a graph. Here you can see that these are different capital of the states of India. They are connected with each other, and if this type of application you want to develop, it is expected that the best suitable data structure is nothing but graph, where the capital, the name of capital or the city, plays the role of vertex, and the connection between them are nothing but the edges, which are useful for relating them with each other or connecting them to each other. So this is nothing but the importance of the graph. Before moving to the representation, you must know few of the terminologies of graph. So they are, the first terminology is nothing but adjacent nodes. Adjacent nodes are nothing but that two nodes who are connected with an edge. That nodes are called as adjacent nodes. So here you can see that this is one example is shown over here, where 0 and 1 are the adjacent nodes. 1 and 2 are also adjacent nodes because they are connected with each other. The terminology used to represent the adjacent node is, in example, 1 and 2, if they are connected with each other, if they are adjacent to each other, so it is called as 2 is adjacent to 1. And if I want to explain it the same thing with respect to vertex 1, it is called as 1 is adjacent from 2. The second terminology is nothing but path. Path is nothing but a sequence of vertices that are used to connect two different nodes, that is right from source to the destination. If we want to find out a path, right from, for example, if you are having a graph of different cities connected to each other, and if you want to move from one city to another city, how I can move from one city to another city, that I can represent with the help of path. That is nothing but the sequence of vertices. They are connected to two separate nodes. For example, this is one example is given over here, from which here you can see that if I want to move from source 0 to destination 2, I have to move through 1, that is hopping will be there from 0 to 1 and 1 to 2 is nothing but a path. Here I have mentioned the same thing, that is 0 to 1, 1 to 2 is nothing but the path for moving from 0 to 2. If I want to move from 1 to 2, there is a direct connection between these two nodes, so they are directly connected with each other. And the third terminology is nothing but a weighted graph. Weighted graph is a graph where the weights are specified on the connected edges. For example, again, if different cities are connected with each other with, for example, road weights. So if I want to move from one city to another city, I should know the distance between that two cities, and that distance is represented with the help of weight on that particular connected edge. So that weight, that value is represents the weighted graph. Here I am having one example, like suppose from 0 to 1 the weight is 15, the value is 15, 1 to 0 it is 10, and 1 to 2 it is 20. So in this way we can represent the weights for the given graph. Why I have mentioned all these things over here? Because the adjacent nodes, path, and the weights, these are the more important terminologies with respect to the graph representation. Again, I am assuming that all of you are knowing the concept of the directed graph and undirected graph. That also very much important with respect to the graph representation. If we are not knowing the concept of connected graph as well as the directed graph, undirected graph, you can go through my previous video where I have already explained the concept of types of graphs. Now let's move for the heart of this session. Video session is nothing but graph representation. Mainly, graph is represented in two ways. The first way is with the help of array data structure. It is called as adjacency matrix. And another way for the representation of graph is nothing but linked list, or with the help of linked list. That is called as adjacency least representation of a graph. So now let's start with the graph representation. The first method is nothing but the adjacency matrix. It is also called as array based representation. And here I am going to explain you the representation with the help of one example. Here you can see that this is the example of graph which is undirected graph, and here I am trying to explain you how to represent this graph with the help of adjacency matrix. Here matrix is mentioned over here. You have to find out how many nodes are there in your graph. That many rows and columns must be there in your adjacency matrix, because every row and every column is going to represent the node. Here I am explaining the same concept. So here you can see that this row is representing A, and this column is also representing the node A. Second row, second column represented by B. Third row, third column will be represented by C, a node C. And the last row, last column will be represented by the last node D. Now, what the next thing I have to do? For the next thing, I have to show here the connection between these different nodes. Suppose, here I am explaining you it with the help of example, where this is a value 0 for A to A connection. There is no any A to A connection, that's why it is 0. B to B, it is also 0. C to C, it is also 0. And D to D, it is also 0. But here you can see that for A, A is connected to node B, A is connected to node C, and A is connected to node D. The same way A is connected to node B, that's why I am representing it with the help of 1. A is connected to C, it is also represented by 1. A is connected to D, it is also represented by 1. And vice versa, B, here you can see that B is connected to A. Here you can see that as it is undirected graph, B is also connected to A, so B to A connection is 1, C to A again connection is 1, and D to A again connection is 1. Here, with the help of this explanation, you must have understood that the rows represented values are nothing but the source node, and the column represented value are nothing but the destination node. Now let's move forward for B. As I explained, B is connected to A, but B is connected to D as well. So here you can see that for the row B, there is a connection between B and D. That's why it is represented by 1. and rest of two are zero as there is no any connection between B to B and B to C. In the same way, for node C, C is connected to A, which I have already explained you. C is also connected to D, so that's why there is a connection between C and D is represented by 1. And the last thing, D is connected to A, B, C, all the three nodes, so that's why this one represents DA connection, this one represents DB connection, and this one represents DC connection. So in this way, I can represent the graph with the help of adjacency matrix. This was the example for undirected graph. Let's move forward for the directed graph. So this is the directed graph, the same graph, only the directions are mentioned as well as the weighted graph, because weights are also mentioned. So if the directions are mentioned, then according to direction only, that many edges will be present in your graph representation as with the help of adjacency matrix, and these ones will be replaced by the weight of that particular edge. So here you can see that this is the matrix, that is 4 by 4 matrix. This is the row column A, row column B, row column C, and row and column for D. Now let's represent this matrix. You can pause your video at this moment. You can try to find out the adjacency matrix for the given directed weighted graph, and then you can check with me. So now let's move forward. So this here you can see that there is a connection between A to B, A to C, and A to D. So that's why it is connected A to B with the weight 20. Here you can see that A to C with weight 25. Here you can see that, and A to D with weight 30. It is mentioned over there. Now there is no any connection between B to A. So that's why B to A weight is 0. There is no any connection between B to C, it is also 0, but there is a connection between B to D, so that's why it is mentioned with its weight is nothing but 50. Now let's move forward for C. C to A, no any connection is mentioned, but here you can see that with respect to B as well as with respect to C, C to A, as the direction is not mentioned, so that's why C to A is also an edge present in the given graph. Same thing for B to A, it is also present as the directions are not mentioned. So that's why if it is directed graph, you have to take care of only the edges which are mentioned with respect to the direction. So that's why C is having only the out degree. Yes, one more point that you have to always keep in mind, that out degree. That many out degree are present for the given node, that many values you have to represent in the adjacency matrix. So here you can see that A is having out degree, that is 3, so that's why 3 values are mentioned over here. For B, out degree is 1, so that's why a single value is there. For C also out degree is 1, so that's why single value is present in our adjacency matrix. And for D, no outer degree is present, so that's why for D all the values are 0. This also will help you to find out the correct adjacency matrix for the given graph. Now let's move forward for the second representation, is nothing but the adjacency least. For representation of or with the help of adjacency least, we have to use the linked least. The same example I am going to explain you with the help of adjacency least. So this is the graph where here I have to find out the adjacency least for all the connected nodes for vertex A. That is, A is connected to B, A is also connected to C, and A is also connected to D. And as here we can see that the three nodes are connected to A, so that's why three nodes will appear in your linked list. And the first node, that is nothing but A, is connected to how many nodes, that you will find out over here. And D is the last node, that's why it is ended with null. Now let's find out the connected nodes for node B, or the adjacent nodes for node B. So here adjacent node to node B are B to A and B to D, that's it. So that's why B adjacency least for node B having holding only two nodes. Now let's find out for C. C is also connected to A and C is also connected to D. So that's why adjacency list for node C holding two values only, and for D again, D is connected to three nodes. So it is connected to A, it is connected to B, it is also connected to C, and here we have done with the adjacency list of D. So in this way you can see that with the help of linked list also we can represent the matrix. Sorry, we can represent the graph. So with the help of these, the concept of the terminology of adjacency node, we are finding the adjacency matrix as well as adjacency list. Whatever the adjacent nodes are there, that we are going to represent with the help of matrix or with the help of linked list. Let's move forward for the one more example for the directed and weighted graph. For the weighted graph, somehow the node structure is different. Here you can see that this is the starting node or a source node from which we are going to find out the adjacent nodes from A. A is adjacent to B with the weight 20. A is adjacent to C with weight 25. And A is adjacent to D with weight 30. So in this way, we can represent the adjacency list for the vertex A with the specified weight and with the specified direction. Let's move forward for the adjacency list for node B. With the help of the knowledge whatever I have explained just now, you can draw the adjacency list for node B by your own, and then you can check it with me. So here B, its out degree is only 1, which is connected with D with the weight 50. Sorry, here it must be 50. Please consider this as 50. So in this way I can connect B with D. And now the last one, that is C, the third one, C is also having out degree 1, so it is connected to D with the weight 45. And the last one, D, there is no any out degree is present, so that's why there will not be any adjacency list available for the node D. So in this way you have to represent the graph with the help of adjacency list if your graph is directed graph and the weighted graph. So thank you dear friends for listening and watching my video. If you like the content and the video, please do not forget to give the comment. You can share this video with your friends as well. If you have not subscribed yet my channel Tech Talks, here I am providing you a subscription link for my channel Tech Talks. Along with this, I am providing you a shortcut link for a next video of this video series, that is nothing but the graph traversal. Along with this, I am providing you the whole playlist for the graph data structure. Thank you and stay tuned with Tech Talks. Happy data structuring, happy learning. Thank you.